Evening.
Good evening.
The old woman watched as under the Mediterranean sun, the workmen carefully dug in the spot she had directed them to. Gradually, one wooden beam was uncovered from the earth. The old woman supervising the dig felt her breath stop and her heart tighten. And as the workers continued to dig, now more excitedly and even more carefully, a second wooden beam emerged from the ground where it had laid for over 300 years. The old woman relaxed her breath and climbed down haltingly into the pit where the two wooden beams rested. She reached out her hand, trembling with joy and fear, to touch them. The old woman had found what her son had sent her to Jerusalem to find, what she desperately had hoped she would discover, the actual cross on which Jesus was crucified and the spot where Jesus had been crucified, Golgotha. The old woman was the Roman Empress Helen, later to become Saint Helen, mother of the Roman Emperor Constantine. And a few years earlier, on the day before the Battle of Milvian Bridge, which would decide whether Constantine or his rival would control the capital city of Rome and be acclaimed emperor, Constantine looked into the sky, and above the sun, he had seen a cross of light and the words, "In this sign, you shall conquer." Constantine did win the battle. Though he was not a Christian, he ended the persecution of Christians throughout the entire Roman Empire because of his vision of the cross. Now, while the Emperor Constantine was not a Christian, his mother Helen certainly was. And in 326 AD, Constantine sent his mother to Palestine to find the holy places connected with the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus so that he could build churches on those spots. And that is why probably sometime the following year, Helen was in Jerusalem, guided to the place, the locations of which the local Christians had preserved in secrecy among themselves, and was able to bring the light of true cross, the cross at which Jesus had died. On that spot in the year 335, Constantine's new church honoring the crucifixion of Jesus would be dedicated. You know, I'm reminded of a story visiting an ill parishioner. And as I watched our pastor anointing a dying woman with the oil of last rites, her son asked, "Could you offer a prayer for healing?" And Father answered that we always pray for the miracle of healing when we anoint. But in other circumstances, he would have told them exactly what I'm telling you today, that when we anoint or baptize or confirm or marry or bury, we are placing a person's life under the power of the thing that is at the very center of our life as Christians, what we live under every day as Christians, the cross of Jesus Christ, on which Jesus lifts up all pain and sorrow and sins and hope and joy for the world with himself, and he carries this to his Father. The sign of Christianity is not something like the star of Judaism, or the sun or the angel of Mormonism. The sign of Christianity is not anything beautiful like the lotus of Buddhism. The sign of Christianity is not a symbol of balance and peace like the yin and yang of Taoism. No, the sign of Christianity is the instrument the government used to execute criminals, enemies of the state. The sign of Christianity is the cross, and it is exactly as if we were to place an electric chair right in front of our church and declare, "This is where God triumphed." Because it is on this cross, executed there as a criminal enemy of the state, that Jesus Christ triumphed and won his victory. It was on the cross, the darkest moment of Jesus' life, when all appeared lost and God seemed absent, that God in Jesus Christ redirected our human history and changed the world. Because on the cross, God descended into the very depths of what it means to be human. The loneliness of death and anguish, of feeling even God is not there, and into the worst of what men and women can possibly do, the torture and execution of the innocent. And there God in Jesus Christ filled that deepest and worst place with his presence, and God was not vanquished. While we prepare to celebrate St. Helen's finding of the true cross of Jesus and the place of crucifixion and the dedication of the church on that very spot, we celebrate even more the hidden truth of that triumphant moment when God in Jesus Christ was lifted up on the cross and all of us were lifted up with him, taking what humans intended for death and making it the source of life. The cross of Jesus was the way in which God engineered his victory for the world. Jesus Christ had to go to the cross with all its shame and bitterness so that there could be no place in our lives where God was not, no place in our lives removed from his life, changing power. Because of Jesus' death on the cross, the Father is able to reveal the victory of God there. That is why we live our entire lives as Christians, from birth to death, under this apparent sign of failure, the sign of the hidden triumph of God, the sign of the cross. It's the sign that's made on our brows when we're baptized. It's the sign that's made over us when our sins are forgiven. It's the sign made on our foreheads when we're chrismated. And it's the sign made on us at our final anointing. And it's also the sign made over our coffins and over our graves and final resting places. The sign of Jesus Christ taking victory out of our hands, we who intended the worst at the darkest moment of the world and changed it all for us to life. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory.
Slava Jesus Christ.